Hi dear students, how are you? After long days, I'm getting the chance to see you. Very nice to see you dear students. I am Selvaras, your geography teacher. I hope all are fit and fine in your home. Dear students, we know that due to the corona pandemic, the whole country has locked down itself. The country is struggling with schools, teachers and lack of education. Most of the schools of the country have started these online classes. Dear students, you must take advantage of this opportunity. Our school management also started this channel for giving the online classes to continue your study. It is easy to make the connection with you all, and it will help us to cover the syllabus and to maintain the flow of study. This connection is not limited to the class, but the session will be available for all. I recommend you take the practice, especially in geography, map, definition, and other facts also. If you have any query, you can ask the WhatsApp group. I welcome you all to join the online classes. I hope to see you soon in the class. Stay home, stay safe. Dear students, in geography, in 7th geography, already we have discussed in our previous session, interior of the earth. First lesson is interior of the earth, and second lesson, landforms. Now, third lesson, we are going to discuss about the topic name is population and settlement. What is the lesson name? Population and settlement. Before we enter inside the lesson, we should understand what is the population. Population geography is nothing but, yes, students, it is a study about or study of demographic phenomena. What is that? Study about demographic phenomena. Demographic phenomena which include natality, which include, what is that? Natality and mortality. What is that? Mortality and growth rates. Growth rates. So here one thing you should understand, dear students, natality. Natality is nothing but birth rate. What is that? Birth rate. And mortality is nothing but, dear students, it is a death rate. Death rate. Okay, so per year, out of 1000, how many number of persons are dying. So now if we take the difference or percentage for this, what is the difference between the birth rate and death rate, that is we said to be growth rates in where, especially populations. Okay, and increase or decrease, what is that? Increase or decrease in population indicates the second point. Increase or decrease in population indicates the distribution of population. What is that? Distribution of populations and growth. Okay, for example, while we are taking the difference between what is that, natality and mortality, so we can find out growth. So that is, what is the name, whether it sometimes it may be increase in populations or decrease in populations. Okay, so that is, what is the name, indicate for us distribution of populations. Okay, and third one is especially the study of the movements. What is the study of the movements and mobility of the population is, we said to be, what is it now, migrations. So migration is nothing but the people is moving from one place to another place for searching the job or doing the agriculture, which means, what is the name, for their own needs. So that we are saying it is a migration. Okay, already we have studied in our lower classes, 6th standard itself. So what is it, especially if you want to take the example birds. So birds are moving from one place to another place based on the climate situations or searching the food like that. Likewise, even if you take the human beings also moving from one place to another place for what? Some fulfill their own needs, so that they are moving from one place to another place, that is we said to be migrations. Okay, next we are going to discuss about the topic name is, dear students, second one is the races. What is that? The races. Race is nothing but, dear students, race has been defined as the biological grouping within the human species. Or otherwise I can give some other definition for races. Race is a group of people with same character or a indistinguishable characteristic inherited. That is also we can say what is that races. Okay, so these races we can classify based on the visual traits. The most widely found human races based on the visual traits such as what is that? Visual traits such as the first one is facial features such as in the facial features the first one is eye shape and the second one is nose shape. color and the second one is what is that in the second point skin color and the third one is the blood groups. Fourth one is the hair types. Fourth one is the hair types. Okay, so we can identify the race of the people based on this visual traits such as facial features, eye shape, nose shape and color, skin color, blood groups and hair types. Okay, so now we are going to discuss about the world human races are the first one is cacti and the second one is negroid and the third one is mongoloid and the fourth one is australoid. So these are the main world major human races. Four categories we can divide or classify. The first one is the caucasoid, negroid, mongoloid and australoid. Okay, now these are the human races. Okay, so in these cases or in these human races we are going to just identify their main classification. The first one is caucasoid. So if you take the caucasoid, they have skin color and eye shape, nose shape and hair types. Okay, so in these cases especially the first one we are going to discuss skin color. Second one is eye color eye color and next third one is nose shape and the fourth one is hair types. Okay, the first one is a caucasoid. Coccidae, they have, those who are belongs to the coccidae races, they have fair skin. They have fair skin. Eye color is dark brown. Dark brown. Nose. They have narrow nose. And hair types. Hair types. Wavy hair. Wavy hair. And next one is Negroid. Negroid, they have black skin. Black skin. And high color, if you take the high color, the first one is a dark brown. Here, dark high. Nose, they have wide nose. And hair, woolly hair. And third one is a Mongoloid. They have, this is the first one, fair skin. Negroid have black skin. And Mongoloid. Mongoloid have light yellow to, what is that? Light yellow to brown skin. Light yellow to brown skin. And high color. High color, brown to dark brown. They have high color, brown to high color. They have brown, brown to dark brown. Dark brown. Dark brown. And a nose, they have medium nose. Medium nose. And hair, they have straight hair. Straight hair. And Australoid. So they have dark skin. They have dark skin. And high color. High color. They have so here dark brown, dark brown to dark brown. So here high color, medium to dark brown. Medium to dark brown. Nose, they have wide nose. Wide nose. And hair types, they have curly hair. What is that? Curly hair. Coccidae is also known as European race. Coccidae is also known as European race. They are found in Eurasia. And in Negroid is what is that? They are living Negroid are living in Africa. And Mongoloid are what is that? Especially living in Asia and Arctic region. And Australia, okay, Australia living in Australia and Asia region. Okay, so these are the world, what is that, major human races. Next we are going to discuss about the topic name is, dear students, races of India. India is said to be one of the most cradle lands of human civilization. India is said to be one of the most cradle lands of human civilization. Civilization. In the ancient Indus Valley civilization. Especially the Dravidian has been believed that has been originated or origin in North India. And the Dravidian people pushed to the south. Later, Indo-Aryan came. Then finally, what happened? So especially the south, what is it? The South India is dominated by the three Dravidian kingdoms, Chera, Chola, Pandya. Okay, the South India is dominated by the three kingdoms. First one is Chera, Cholas and Pandyas. So in the South India, what happened, especially different kinds of Dravidian peoples were there. They used to be speak some languages such as Tamil and Kannada, Telugu, Malayalam and also Tulu. So these are the small, what is that, explanation about what is the race of India. Next we are going to discuss about the topic name is, dear students, religion. What is that? Religion. Religion is nothing but it is a particular system. What is that? Particular system of faith and worship. Particular system of faith and worship, which brings human being with the human society. Okay, and religion is a, what is it, symbol of the people, symbol of the people. And if, what is it, we can classify the religion also. There are three categories. The first one is what, especially universalizing religion. First one is a universalizing religion. In this, if you take the universalizing religion, there are three categories are there. The first one is Christianity. What is that? Christianity. First one is Christianity. Second one is Islam. Third, first one is Christianity, second one is Islam, and third one is Buddhism. So this belongs to universalizing religion. And next one is the second one, ethnic religion. What is that? Ethnic religion. In this ethnic religion, the first one is Judaism, and the second one is, first one is Judaism, second one is Hinduism, and third one is Shintoism. Okay, and the third one is the traditional religion. Traditional, what is that? Traditional religion. Traditional religion. In this traditional religion, the first one is, first one is traditional religion, animism. Second one is shamanism. Third one is Samana. So these are the classification of religion. Okay dear students, next we are going to discuss about the topic name is language. Language is nothing but, dear students, it is the great force of socialization. What is it? Great force of socialization. Socialization. So this is said to be language. Language either in the form of written or oral, it is a type of communications. And it is used to or promote the deliver our ideas or communicate each other and to promote the economic, social and religious. These are what is that now is use of language. Okay, so if you want to be just express our ideas or our feelings, if you want to be our share, so language is playing very major role between each other for all these things. Okay, so now the world main major languages such as Tamil, Hindi, English, Chinese, Portuguese and Arabic, Russian and some other languages. This is said to be what is it main major languages. Next we are going to discuss about the topic name is, dear students, languages. What is it? Languages of India. India has many languages and culture, dear students. Especially each and every state has its own language. Each and every state has its own language. And there are totally 22 languages recognized by our Indian constitution. If you take the North India, the different types of people used to speak Hindi, Punjabi, Assami, Bengali, like that different languages they are used to speak in a North India. So if you take the South Indian people mostly used to speak the Dravidian languages such as Tamil, Telugu, Malayalam, Kannada. So these are the, what is that, short introduction or explanation about the languages of India. Thank you, dear students. Stay home, stay safe.